As a military service member, a family member, or as a veteran who proudly served, you are aware of the potential hazards of military service. But what should you do if you are experiencing health issues that are difficult to diagnose or medically unexplained? How can you and your healthcare team work together to manage symptoms that are consistent with chronic multisymptom illness, or CMI? CMI is an important health concern for service members and veterans. It is also a critical healthcare issue for the Veterans Health Administration and the Department of Defense.
I'm an internist and I've specialized in post-deployment healthcare. I'm also a primary care provider. So I've spent 16 years working in the VA helping veterans with deployment-related health concerns. Chronic multisymptom illness is one of those concerns. I think the most important thing for providers to know about CMI is what it is and how to recognize it.
To assist healthcare teams in delivering the best patient-centered care focused on improving health outcomes for individuals with CMI, DoD and VA experts have worked together to develop a clinical practice guideline.
I'm a doctor at Walter Reed National Military Medical Center. I train in both internal medicine and psychiatry. Military providers need to be aware of the clinical practice guidelines for chronic multisymptom illness in order to provide care for active duty service members, family members, and retirees. The CPG can help us do that.
Chronic multisymptom illness is a term used by the medical community for chronic medically unexplained symptoms. While it can exist in civilian populations, for veterans and service members, CMI includes military-specific medically unexplained illnesses, such as Gulf War illness, Gulf War syndrome, or other post-deployment syndromes including chronic fatigue syndrome, fibromyalgia, and irritable bowel syndrome. Symptoms vary, but can include combinations of excessive tiredness, headaches, concentration or attention problems, changes in mood, muscle or joint pain, cough, sore throat, ear or nasal symptoms, or stomach and digestive problems. If you, as a service member or veteran, have multiple symptoms like these lasting longer than 6 months, ask your healthcare provider about an evaluation for CMI and work closely with your healthcare team on the best way to manage your symptoms.
The clinical practice guideline is a great resource for providers because it, first of all, defines what CMI is. It talks about what some of the risk factors are for a chronic multisymptom illness. And then really importantly, it talks about the general management strategies as well as some very specific treatment options that may work for your patient.
A toolkit has been developed to give veterans, service members, and their healthcare providers access to the CMI Clinical Practice Guideline and other useful resources. Visit the U.S. Army Medical Department Office of Quality Management website and the VA-DoD Clinical Practice Guidelines website for more information on obtaining toolkit items. The CMI toolkit includes a summary of the CMI Clinical Practice Guideline, a CMI pocket card for healthcare providers, and frequently asked questions for patients and family members.
The Clinical Practice Guidelines includes the basics and framework of providing the recommendations of care for patients experiencing chronic multisymptom illness.
The full CPG can be found at this website. Here, healthcare providers will find valuable CMI management strategies, including a collaborative, team-based approach, the use of shared decision-making principles to develop a comprehensive and personalized treatment plan, and critical domains where enhanced knowledge may be beneficial when caring for patients with CMI. Using the tools and strategies in the CMI Clinical Practice Guideline can improve health outcomes and help providers to optimize the use of available therapies to reduce the symptoms of CMI and enhance quality of life, minimize preventable complications, and emphasize the use of personalized, proactive patient-driven care. By taking the time to learn more about these tools, we can accomplish the mission of improved care and quality of life.